Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today's topic is the elongation of prokaryotic translation. But before watching this, please go through our previous video on initiation of prokaryotic translation. Link is given in the description below. Following the completion of translation initiation, the process of elongation commences. The elongation phase proceeds one codon at a time until it encounters a stop codon. At the conclusion of initiation, if met tRNA was bound by hydrogen bonds to the AUG codon located in the P site of the ribosome. The forthcoming codon is positioned in the A site. The codon present in UCC, which signifies the amino acid serine. In the cytoplasm, the tRNA carrying serine forms a complex with EFTU and GTP. The resulting AcrTRNA-EFTU-GTP complex makes its way into the A site, where the tRNA's anticodon establishes hydrogen bonds with the UCC codon. When the binding occurs, GTP undergoes hydrolysis, leading to the release and recycling of the EFTU. With the tRNA molecules present in both the P and A sites, a peptide bond is able to form between the adjacent amino acids. Peptidyl transferase, which is found in the large subunit of the ribosome, catalyzes this reaction. The initial step is the breaking of the bond between FMET and its associated tRNA in the P site. Subsequently, a peptide bond is established between the liberated FMET and the serine, which remains attached to its tRNA in the A site. The formation of a peptide bond is a condensation reaction which results in the liberation of water. After the peptide bond is formed, the P site contains an uncharged tRNA, while the A site holds a tRNA linked to the nascent polypeptide chain. Assisted by EFG and another molecule of GTP, the ribosome shifts one codon down the mRNA strand. The ribosome binds to an EFG-GTP complex, which triggers the hydrolysis of GTP and initiates the translocation process. The uncharged tRNA transitions from the P site to the E site, preventing any new aminoacyl tRNA from binding to the A site until the translocation is finalized. Once the tRNA is securely positioned in the P site, the uncharged tRNA is expelled from the E site. With the A site now vacant, it is ready to receive the next aminoacyl tRNA, thus allowing the elongation cycle to persist. Typically, a polypeptide is composed of approximately 300 amino acids. Let's observe the elongation phase once more.